Deep in West Texas, one oil rig is in a battle.
Come on, guys, come on! Oh. Come on! Oh. Watch him!
With itself.
Welcome to the oil field!
F*** you, mother...
It's their biggest gamble yet.
Go wild, guys, baby! Let's get that oil!
The stakes have never been higher.
If we don't hit, I don't know how many millions, but it's gonna be a huge loss for you.
We need to hit this one.
She's got a gun.
She's got a gun.
Now, one angry rancher...
Take this rig and get the hell out of here.
...can put a stop to it.
They're gonna respect me, or they can get the out.
And all hell will break loose.
Get on it! Get on it!
The pressure is building.
Good, I'm good.
I'll get your bitch ass.
All for a taste.
Love it. Love it. Want some more of it.
Of black gold. On black gold.
You're gonna be f***ing around.
Tank keeps pushing his luck.
Next time, I will run you off.
And it's pulling him apart.
You can't f*** me around. I'll get rid of you.
With a friend like Brandon.
I bought the f***ing charity in my mother.
Cheston has all the enemies he needs.
You let it go!
You let it go,
I ain't gonna play the game.
And just 400 feet from Judgment Day.
Hey!
They're either gonna shape up or they're out of here.
Time is running out for the roughnecks of Rig 28.
Find out who he is and he's gone.
Go, let's go! You shut that valve, Greg, or no?
Getting real close, baby.
After three grueling weeks of wildcatting, the roughnecks of Rig 28 are close to the bottom of the well.
Hope like hell that we got some oil. Hopefully we'll get this sucker to pay off for the big wig so that they can keep signing my checks.
Hurry up!
As long as we got jobs, that's all I'm really hoping for.
The crew's feeling the heat.
Yeah!
Because if there's no oil, they're all out of a job. With so much at stake,
where's Cheston at?
Cheston's nowhere to be found.
Anybody seen Cheston?
That's a very good question.
Who the is Cheston?
Cheston's out around.
How does that mother keep disappearing?
This close to the bottom, driller Ben Green is gonna make Cheston carry his weight.
Man, I just had to set the bushings on my own, dude.
When I pick up, man, I gotta have y'all up there. All right. Like, no ifs, ands, or buts.
Gotcha. All right, bud.
Brandon!
What?
But Cheston just doesn't take his roughnecking seriously.
Put your mask on!
You. That's all that man does is talk. He always wants to get in my business. He got something. Why can't he do something else instead of me all damn day?
I can't apologize about a can of Miracle Whip, fool.
Lately, Justin's been standing up for himself. Been testing the limits with Brandon. But messing with Brandon is playing with fire.
Huh? What are you down here bitching about?
About you?
What about?
You always up here talking. Now, every time I look at you, you're bumping your damn boot.
Look like your boyfriend dressed for work today.
Brandon and Cheston have a love-hate relationship. Cheston loves Brandon, but Brandon hates Cheston.
What have you been doing? That driller looking for you all the time. There he is.
Oh, that's the time.
Where's Cheston? He said, where's Cheston? I don't know. He's in there and Ben said, no, he walked out. He's somewhere else. I don't know where he's at.
Bull.
Yeah.
I went up there and told him. I said, hey, I was making that last connection. What do you want me to do?
He just wants to know where you're at. Make sure you're working. If you can't hang out with me and get done, you need to do
something. You've been everything they've asked me to do.
You ain't been on the floor. You haven't. Sit there and f***ing lie to me because I've been up there throwing your damn tongue.
Because you wanted to.
You told me.
Yeah, because I know you like to.
Yelling at me. Yelling at me. Shut the f*** up. Shut up. Go. Get the f*** out of here.
Get the f*** out of here.
Go. 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 Yeah. Yeah.
Justin backs down from what could have been turned into a fight.
No, we just jack with each other. Sometimes it gets serious out here, but I know Brandon well enough to where we're joking around and when we're not.
But Justin will soon find out he doesn't know Brandon as well as he thinks. Forty miles away, a roughneck who was canned by Big Dog.
Keep you going.
Yeah, I'm going home.
Struggles to make a living the only way he knows how, by drilling holes. Water drilling is Gerald's last option, and if he can't find water to lubricate the hole, his well, along with his career, is gonna dry up.
Damn water truck hadn't showed up yet. I've got to prime my pump, get you going. I need a little bit of water here from somewhere. And I need about 15, 20 gallons of water to get started.
His only option is the kindness of strangers.
I'll see what these people think about it. You know, you always hate to encounter dogs because you never know what they're going to do. Some of them friendly, some of them are not. We encounter a few of them that'll put you on the run, but most of the time we can outrun them. No car in the driveway, didn't like anybody's around. So I'm gonna snoop around a little bit, see if I can't find me a water drop, see if I can't hook a hose up and give me a little bit of water. Maybe they won't shoot me when they come home. Snooping around an empty house in Texas, get a man shot real damn quick.
With no one home, Gerald consults the only authority in sight.
Can I steal some of your water?
And fortunately, Gerald hears what he wants to hear.
Well, I got it hooked up here to this man's well.
Hey, you there! What the hell do you think you're doing? Can I suggest you get off of my property? You do it now. Who the hell gave you permission to get over here? What the hell are you doing with my water? This is my This is my well. This is my land.
I understand that.
So you tell me what you're doing.
Well, if you'll quit screaming at me, I will.
Well, you better start talking. You better start talking real damn quick.
I didn't mean to make you mad. I was just drilling water on your property across the street from you over there. My water truck hadn't showed up, and I needed about 20 gallons of water.
Who the hell gave you permission to come over here and just take what you wanted?
Well, nobody.
This is my land. You do understand, do you not?
I do.
That this is trespassing on somebody else's property.
I understand.
You do understand, do you not, that that is a criminal offense?
I do.
You do understand, do you not, that I could call the sheriff's department, have them come out, and have your damn ass arrested? Do you understand that?
How about I give you $50
for your water? I don't want your damn money.
Oh, now, come on.
You know what? I'm going to call the sheriff. Do you realize what you did is criminal trespass?
I do.
Do you realize I can call the sheriff's department? I can get your ass arrested.
I understand that.
I don't care who you are or what you think you're doing. I want you to get that hose, and I want you to get your damn ass off my property.
Baby, I'm going. I'm going.
Do you understand? You have not heard the last of this.
All right. Thank you, ma'am. You have a good day. I got quite a few holes to drill, and really didn't have time to wait. So if all I got to do is take an ass eating once in a while to keep me ahead of track, well, that's ass eating I'll take with a smile. Whew, glad that over with.
Coming up, Brandon and Cheston throw down.
You mother.
And fight dirty.
What's your problem?
Then later.
You gonna tell him whether it's a bust?
Dirty. At dawn, the Roughnecks gather for the daily safety meeting.
New name brand out there.
They can't start until the new Roughneck shows up.
This is my first day on the job. Can't be late.
Jordan Fuller is tool pusher Jerry Chansey's grandson. And he's running 20 minutes late.
I heard all kinds of crazy stories, a lot of fighting out here, but I definitely have a lot to live up to as far as the Chansey name goes. Driving?
You're late.
No, I'm not.
Day one in the worm's late. Not the best of starts for the new hire and his tool pusher grandfather.
I don't have to put up the
This is Oscar. Or he's your boss.
Yes, sir.
You do what he says.
Yes, sir.
That's Tank.
Hey, man.
Twist.
Good night, man.
Josh.
What's up, bro? Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
You just listen to them. You do what they tell you.
Yes, sir.
Especially this one.
Yes, sir.
If you don't, he will kick your ass.
Yes, sir.
When he gets through kicking your ass, I'll kick your ass.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
So you do what you're told. Okay, get out of here.
Today's gonna be a test for me and a test for the hands. I got Derek Hanna I haven't worked with. I got a floor crew that don't got that much experience, so it's gonna be a test for all of us.
Oh my gosh, what a day.
Hopefully they can keep up, and if they don't, then I'll move them off my floor and get somebody else to.
As the sun rises, Oscar gives the worm a crash course.
Use your legs, all right? If not, then use your back. You're gonna hurt your back.
Roughnecking 101.
If I'm ever on that brake handle, whatever you do, don't stand right here.
He knows rookies make the rig more dangerous and slows drilling down.
Just watch out for everybody. No matter how much you trust anybody, always watch out. You know, when you get in a hurry, that's when accidents happen, you know what I'm saying?
So far, I'm taking in a lot, so it's definitely teaching me quite a bit at one time.
I get it right the first time. Trying to slow my hands down.
Me and my family have been through hell, back and forth, so I'm actually more here for my family than I am for myself. What's really at stake for me is just making sure that I can get it done, where I can send them money and I can help my family. I come from a line of roughnecks. I gotta make them proud.
The roughnecks want to make sure he doesn't get special treatment.
He won't get treated no differently. He's gonna be a worm. He's an officer's crew. You're gonna be there with the best. You're gonna be with the rest.
And his grandfather agrees.
Run on his ass.
I'll run on his ass for you, Jerry.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure he's gonna make a good hand.
I hope he does.
If he got your blood in it.
Very little of it, most of it. Grandma.
Get all that mud out there.
Oscar gives Jordan his first job, clearing debris out of the shaker.
There's only one way to learn, that's to get your feet wet.
It's a task even a worm can't screw up.
Man, anytime you got a new guy like that, that guy knows nothing. So that means you have to watch everybody else and then watch him even more, you know what I mean?
The worm needs watching, because he's not doing it right.
Hey! Hey! Damn it! Watch this, the truck. See that right there? Get a shovel and start digging that out.
Yes, sir.
With the mud not flowing.
This thing got backed up. We can't drill with this.
The drill bit could get stuck.
Come on, guys, hurry, come on.
And shut drilling down.
Hey, find another shovel, man, come on. Hurry, come on. Damn it. Tank, help him out, Tank.
All right, get up there.
Come on, hey, hey, come on. Jerry said, you know, do whatever you can. If it means riding them, I'm gonna ride them. They're gonna ride until he breaks. That's the only way to do it.
I didn't know you were talking about this down there, my bad.
All right, you'll get used to it. You'll get used to me getting on your ass. You know, every hand I've ever had works out one way or the other. Either he works out here or he works at home.
The mud's moving so the roughnecks can start drilling.
Hey, get tank up here, let's get this motherfucker.
But the worms just getting in the way.
Take him up, pick him up a little. No, pick his up a little. Wiggle your ass in that way. Wiggle your ass in that way.
Working with three worms on the floor is really dangerous. It's like three monkeys football.
Water, 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 go. Water. Ow. Yeah. Come out, Dad.
So far, the worm's 0 for 2. He delayed the morning safety meeting, and he nearly shut the rig down single-handedly.
Zip up your pants, it's gonna cut you out. Why was you late this morning?
I was in the truck.
Well, I'm gonna ride your ass up there tomorrow. We can't have it.
Jerry knows he's gotta make an example of Jordan, not only because the roughnecks are watching.
I think he feels like since his grandpa's a tool pusher, maybe he's tool pusher junior. I mean, that's fly here, dude.
But also for Jordan's safety.
He is a worm. And if he can't make them safety meetings, then he may accidentally get hurt, and then I'd feel guilty. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna write your ass up. It's a warning. I'm doing it more for you, really, because you're a worm. And if you don't make the safety meetings, you'll liable to get up there and get hurt. Sign it and date it down here. And make sure it don't happen again. Because you're part of me, I don't like doing it. But everybody will get pissed off and everything if I show you favoritism, and I'm not going to do it. Okay, get out of here.
I'm definitely not getting special treatment. Hopefully, me getting written up proves it to all the rest of the crew.
After time off, Brandon and Cheston are back at work.
Get the up! Shut up!
Go! Get the out of here!
Get the out of here!
Go! Go! Go!
But they still haven't forgiven each other.
He acts like a woman. He bitches and nags like a woman. He can snap and yell all he wants. You know, if he puts his hands on me, that's a different story, you know? So he can make himself look like an idiot all the time.
The last thing Brandon wants is help from Cheston.
How many more sacks you got to miss?
That's all that man does is talk. He always wants to get in my business. He does something. Why can't he do something else instead of with me off?
You obviously need my help. You're asking my help. Fucking open these sacks up and miss them. I'm going home by you. Hurry up, fool. Stop throwing sacks at me! Stop throwing sacks at me, ho! You see me working? You mother! What's your problem? What the fuck you do by yourself, dude?
Well, then get the out of here, then! Then get the out of here, then!
I am!
Cheston backs down, but Brandon can't let it go.
Cheston's being a damn little baby.
Well, that sacks weigh about 100 pounds apiece. I mean, if you ain't looking, damn it, it's gonna hurt. It ain't no joke, man.
Brandon's not used to Cheston fighting back.
But he thinks he can just, you know, pull like that over here. I ain't gonna stand for it, man.
And he's gonna make him pay.
He better start throwing punches instead of jail sacks.
Coming up.
What's your problem?
Brandon and Cheston's furious battle.
Why'd you throw the sack at me?
Goes down the toilet.
Let me out, please. No! I'm gonna leave you in there.
And later, the threat of being shut down has the Roughnecks at each other's throats.
I'll knock his jaw on the back of his head.
Do whatever you gotta do, pick him up a little.
Just 200 feet from the bottom of the Wildcat well.
Yeah. Pick him up, get him on there. Come on, brother.
Rookie driller Ben Green and his Roughnecks are focused on striking oil and keeping their jobs.
There you go, now you're working.
But Derrick man Brandon Watson's focused on something else. Putting Cheston back in his place.
Stop throwing sacks at me, ho!
What's your problem? Job, big dog, I'd go to work for another damn company. But I'm not gonna sit here and let that mother talk and throw damn jail sacks at me.
Pick him up!
Shut up! Pick him up! Go talk, do your job!
Damn! You need to stay over there on the fence and do your job.
Brandon's anger turns him into a menace on the rig floor.
Pick him up!
Pay attention!
Watch out!
I ain't in your face, motherfucker!
Still a me, bro.
Yeah, at least you can throw me when I'm looking, instead of when I'm not looking.
Damn it! Really?
Though he's not happy about fighting on the drilling floor, Ben Green looks the other way to keep the work moving.
Timber flaring don't distract me much. Happens all the time out here.
Oh! Come here. Put me in my hut, money house, mother. I'm gonna come with you a little bit.
Well,
see how you like it. You're still a.
Push him down.
You're still a.
Hey, buddy.
All right. Let's say you need to stop going fuck you, send it. Damn, you don't.
Thanks for the help, man. Working himself up over nothing. Making it worse on everybody.
How come you didn't throw it at me when I was looking at you? Huh?
You throwing bags when I wasn't looking? Hit me right in the face.
You were looking right in my face. I didn't throw a full bag of jail at you. So you. What, you don't want to talk now or what?
Nope, not really. What are we going to accomplish? We ain't going to accomplish nothing.
Go scrub the sub.
You don't need to tell me what to do. Go get on your pants.
Brandon drove Cheston off the rig floor. But he's still not satisfied.
What's your problem?
But the problem is Brandon's. He's looking for unconditional respect on an oil rig.
What's wrong with you?
I don't know.
And Cheston's just sick of giving it.
Don't throw it at me. Why'd you throw the sack at me?
I'm glad I drove to work today.
Testing your blood. Testing your blood, motherfucker.
Ain't no water.
That's what I meant to
tell you, motherfucker.
I'll make your life miserable on this rig.
Here. I mean, if anyone's come over here and throw my hard hat, it never ends, man. His problem is, though, every time he wants my help, he wants to holler, like.
He's over here standing on the damn handrails, so I said, get your ass over here and make some money. You gonna sit there and do nothing?
It'll blow over. I just stay out of his way. Stay out of mine.
You cooled off yet? Are you cooled off yet?
Just cut it out, man. You blowing water at me and you're getting yourself wet.
Are you cooled off yet?
Somebody needs to put a chain on him to where he can only reach from one end of the pit to the other end of the pit. That's all he needs to do is stay on that pit with a chain around his neck.
Cheston keeps calm. But a man can only take so much before he's pushed over the edge.
I'm tired of him yelling at me, you know? Like, he can only yell at me so much.
I'm not f***ing around.
Despite the distractions, the rookie driller is just 5 feet from the bottom of the Wildcat well.
gotta do is go down, drill about a foot, and that'll be TD.
The long-awaited end to the Wildcat hole is near.
Yeah, break sweep three more times, and I can go kick it out.
That's it! That's TD!
Yeah! The Roughnecks of Rig 28 have put a hole 2.3 miles into the earth.
It's a good day today, baby. It's a good day.
What's up, buddy? Congratulations.
Thank you.
They're celebrating now, but the Roughnecks' jobs aren't in the clear. They still have to pull all the pipes so Big Dog's geologists can test for oil. In the meantime...
Yeah, sometimes it's better to get even and, you know, get mad at somebody.
Brandon's determined to have the last laugh on Cheston.
Little, let's see how he likes it.
Come on!
I'm gonna leave you in there. Might as well call your girlfriend.
Come on.
What?
Let me out, please.
No. Yeah. Tell me you're sorry.
Sorry.
That ain't good enough.
Uh-huh.
You know, I had to smell his own for about 15 minutes till I let his ass out.
Let me finish my cigarette and then I'll open the door. Come on.
Apologize one more time.
Sorry. What? I'm sorry.
Brandon, once again, has the upper hand with Cheston.
I love pissing him off, man. It makes my day. And that was funny. It was great, man. I loved it.
Coming up, the worm takes a bath. And later...
All right, bye. Sorry, but we don't have another well for y'all.
Okay.
It's almost judgment day for the Roughnecks of Rig 28.
Yeah, right now I'm treating pipe. I'm breaking out my hands the way I want to do it. I just got to keep on moving. I don't want to stay still too long.
They got to drag 2 miles of pipe out of the hole.
Help them out. Get those lifts ready. Pick them up.
Up.
Come on, guys, come on.
To find out if they hit oil.
Take it off.
Or if they're out of their jobs.
Hey. Oh, here.
And to make matters worse, they gotta pull off their toughest day with a worm. Tool pusher Jerry Chansey's grandson.
I've never done it, so I can't really forget what turbine pipe's like.
Put the thongs on, baby boy. Drop them down. Got time for none of this. I know you haven't done it much, but you got to move.
Though Jordan has spent just days in the oil field.
I hate this job. I don't like this job.
He's already over the work and the Roughnecks.
They're small-minded. They're in the oil field, that's probably what they're gonna do for the rest of their life. That's all they really look forward to doing, is staying out here. I don't.
And his attitude isn't winning their respect.
Watch your face.
It's like he's better than everybody else, but he don't know shit out here. That shit ain't gonna fly in my book.
I don't know what the hell this kid's problem is, though.
Yeah, he wants me to teach him how to fight. You know, if he wants to spar me, I'll knock his jaw off the back of his head.
All right, open him up, let's go.
But driller Oscar Barreras couldn't care less about roughneck politics.
Rock and roll, baby. A little bit more.
Easy, hey.
Don't guess he thought it's easy.
Joints to lay out today. It's gonna be a hard day, but it'll go by fast for these boys.
Yeah.
what the guys did today. Real pleased.
Everything's going great, man.
Hell yeah. Ben did a great job today on the break. Today we tripped out 12,370 foot of pop in 6 hours. I'm pleased. I'm proud of everybody on the crew. My drill did a kick-ass job. We did a f***ing awesome job today. I mean, hands down, we're some bad motherfuckers.
Now it's time for the mud logger to test the well and see if it'll deliver oil.
They're deciding on, from these prints, what they're gonna get out of this well. It goes on and on and on. So this is gonna tell them whether it's a bust or a boom.
In less than 12 hours, the boys of Big Dog will learn their fate. Coming up, the Roughnecks go too far.
I'm not playing. They will get off my land.
In downtown Midland, oil man Autry Stevens is about to find out if his wildcat gamble paid off.
It's a verdict.
No oil shows at all.
What happened?
The pay zone disappeared.
Well, that's kind of a blow, isn't it?
It is, definitely. No gas, no sample shows, no pay. So it was high and dry.
Well, that's a disappointment.
Autry's $2 million bet is a bust.
This business is full of disappointments. And I guess this is one of those, the agony of a defeat.
Wildcat just didn't pan out.
...25 miles away on Big Dog 28, Freddie Moore's just received bad news from the company man.
All right, bye.
And now he's got the difficult job of telling his crew.
Hey, Oscar, you think you get all your guys up here for me?
Yeah.
Well, there's two of them there. Come here, guys. This wildcat well, it didn't really perform like they wanted it to. I mean, I know it wasn't up to us where they put this rig at, but it just didn't perform like they wanted it to.
The office puts it over on us pushers, you know. They're gonna tell us, hey, sorry, but we don't have another well for y'all, you know. You tell them hands, you tell them drillers.
Walter and David Kaiser's coming out here after a while to tell me what's gonna happen, if we're gonna move somewhere, or if we're gonna put her in the grass.
Well, the reason why they call it wildcat, you know, I mean, we did what we came here to do, but it didn't work out.
Dog eat dog, man. I mean, they don't care about us, dude. They work us like slaves, pay us like slaves. And I mean, there's no job security in it, obviously. I mean, you show up every day. And I mean, you're gonna stack my rig because y'all didn't find oil?
The oil feels like anything else in life, man. You know what I mean? The rich get richer, and if the poor get dude, that's just the way it is. I mean, they make the calls, they lose money. We're out of a job. We lose all of our money.
The Roughnecks decide to wash down the news of a dry well with some cold beers.
Right.
I was happy to see where we were at. Look out, you could see Luke 250.
All that work, dude, all that going wrong, it was a duster.
Yeah, maybe we'll get better on this all, bro.
Landowner Peggy Hauser is the last person they wanted to see.
Ain't that some
That's the chick from the rig.
What the Why she got a gun, dude? Oh, my God.
Hi. You guys in a hurry?
Yes.
Where are you going?
I'm going to work.
You work on this rig?
Yes, ma'am.
The next time you fly down this road, I'm blowing your tires out.
Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Peggy.
We'll buy her a beer.
Just, you gotta caress it. Miss Peggy.
Son of a...
That is her.
How are y'all?
We recognized you and we just wanna say hi.
Hi.
You wanna have a beer with us?
No. What are y'all doing here?
We're just trying to have a beer, man, trying to enjoy one.
So y'all are drilling on my land and now you're drinking in my bar.
We didn't know this was your bar.
Yeah.
Well, we like to call it our bar on our days off.
No, I'm tired of seeing y'all. I've been out there. I see y'all speeding down my road, throwing trash, not picking it up.
I'm the janitor on that bitch. I ain't gonna lie. That's all I do is pick up trash. Y'all's trash.
They're not mine. I'm a go green kind of guy. I put my trash in.
And I don't smoke.
I don't care whose trash it is. You guys are gonna keep it clean. You're not gonna speed down my road.
Why are you the way you are, Peggy? Really?
Because I own that land and you guys are gonna respect it. And if you don't like it, there's the door. Just finish your beer and get the f out. I know you gotta be at the rig tomorrow, so. Are we clear?
Clear. Better yet, I'm not even thirsty anymore. You thirsty?
Keep talking.
I'm just saying.
Keep talking. All right, y'all have a good one.
Yeah.
What do you think?
Told you, bro.
Well, I don't care. I don't want to be here anymore anyways.
She's surrounded by negative.
Well, I tried.
Coming up.
Company man!
Looks like we didn't hit what we were looking for here.
Hey, Twist! Come here!
When Twist pulls down his pants.
Really? Is that guy? I don't need to see all that.
Peggy threatens to pull the lease. Big Dog Brass is heading to Rig 28 to deliver the Roughnecks' fate.
Company man!
The Roughnecks' only hope is that the company honors Peggy's lease and continues to drill.
How are you doing today, Sean?
Doing great, doing great. Just come out to visit a minute.
Looks like we didn't hit what we were looking for here. A lot of people disappointed, but talking to the geologist, the geophysicist, they seem to pick one more spot.
Okay.
So we're gonna be moving, probably move Saturday, and move over to that next location, try it again.
Well, my guys will be happy to hear that part, that we got another one to go to.
Well, I know. That's the reason I want to let you know for sure that we do have another location. I want the hands to know, you know, we need to take care of our people. Well, we really do, so.
We appreciate that.
All right.
Good seeing you again, Walter.
Take care.
What's up, Freddy?
Well, we got another well to go to.
So, us having our jobs, is that still up in the air, or?
Well, we're going to drill another wildcat. We, you know, it goes from well to well.
Back to work. 1, 2, 3. Bang!
If the next hole comes up dry, the hands will certainly lose their jobs. But for now, work on Rig 28 goes on.
You're always relieved that you got another well to go to. It puts me at ease and it puts my hands at ease.
After almost losing his job, Jordan's making more concrete plans.
I'm gonna go off to Hollywood, try either acting or modeling. I really don't know what's in the works for me. Plus, I'm writing a book on my life. I would tell you the title, but I don't want that. I don't want it spread out. But look forward to Jordan Fuller's book on his life because it's definitely coming out. I've been working on it for the past 2 years.
That dude's so full of man. I think he's got something coming for us. Hey, dude, you know what we need to do?
Huh?
We need to get that dumbass worm, dude. Turn him as a plug out there in the reserve, bro. Get him to go out there and pull it.
I'm down, dude.
Hey, hey, hey!
They run a pipeline out from the outside, all the way under. You have to pull it. There's like a dude. And if you can't reach it with the hook, you're getting in there, because I'm clean.
A roughneck would know that there's no drain at the bottom of this plastic lined pit, but a worm's got no idea.
I think it's right there, but what the f do I do? Just walk out there?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Halfway, this way.
He's out there right now looking for a drain plug in a on a dirt ground.
Like right in there somewhere. Give me that shovel.
Man, quit being a pussy and feel for that hoe, dude. Dang.
He said, f it. He said, let them get it.
We'll save it for next year.
Oh, I love my job. Woo! Motherfucker. I ain't never got nobody to do that. That's awesome. I went out there for nothing. Easy. And some salty money. And my boots are full of it. And all for nothing. Get the table to make them laugh.
The roughnecks got 3 weeks left on Peggy's land. Woo! And she's always watching.
Looks like everybody's doing what they're supposed to be doing.
If Peggy's gonna look, they're gonna give her something to look at.
Ah. Is he really? Really? Is that guy? I don't need to see all that. I'm not playing, I'm not bluffing. I will go downtown and tell Autry, if these boys can't play by my rules, they will get off my land.
Next week on Black Gold.
Don't never call nobody on me.
Push comes to shove with the tool pushers.
I'll kick the damn out of you. You think I won't walk out that door and we'll see.
And one of them's gotta go.
Fat Freddy packed all his. If he's gone, he's gone.
And later.
I told y'all don't. I told all y'all that.
They're having a blast.
Rusty!
In West Texas.
It's original.